Hey guys, so funny moments are plentiful working with high school students, and I pretty much only work with 9th grade students at this point, but I felt really weird when at one point there was a student that's really enthusiastic about joining our kind of a group therapy kind of thing that we do, and most of the members in that group don't want to be in group, mainly because we hold those groups on their lunch periods. You know, of course, they would rather hang out with their friends than come to a room or a gym setting and try to do things together with other high school kids that they are not necessarily that familiar with, and with staff members like me and the other social worker. It's totally understandable that they would feel that way. But anyway, this kid, he loves being in the group. He was like, I want to join the group, I want to join the group. And he's been like that for a long time. They finally let him in. But anyway, like, there was one time he just was really, like, upfront and was just like, Mr. David, you should be why aren't you a teacher? You should be a teacher. I think you would be a really cool teacher. And he said that to me, and I was like, I didn't really know what to say, but my initial thought was just like, what? Like, I had a weird response, like, weird reaction to that, in, like, inside. You know, I didn't really say anything to him. I was like, oh, yeah, well, I mean, you know, well, yeah, that's okay. Thanks. but it's weird that the initial kind of question I had in my mind was like, no way, like, why would I want to be a teacher? That's like a thankless profession, or, you know, underappreciated thing. And then I had that thought, and I'm just like, wait a minute, why am I thinking that when I'm in social work, which is also like one of the most underappreciated, thankless profession. And so I was just like, I was having a reaction to my reaction, and just like, why am I thinking that way? But I think it really is because I have kind of worked with teachers before, not in a teaching capacity, but, well, I was a classroom tutor at one point. That was my job at one point. And it's just like, seeing what the teachers go through, I guess, to me, it's a tough profession, I think, teaching. And that's because it doesn't just involve teaching. So if teaching was just teaching, I would love to be a teacher right away. Like, if all I had to do was kind of prepare my lesson plans and to interact with the kids and teach that lesson plan and kind of just have that discussion of, like, what you learn and kind of check their progress in that, if that was all that teaching entailed in elementary schools or kindergarten or middle school or high school, I would love to teach high school if that was the case. If that was all that teaching was, yeah, you know, shoot, I'll be on board, you know. And if I ended up going to a different college instead of New York University, in fact, I most likely would have ended up an American history teacher anyway. So that was kind of like, okay, yeah, like, if teaching is that, then that would be great. But no, there's much more involved in teaching. And I don't want to do any of the other things, you know, having to work, you know, you have your one classroom most, you know, a lot of the times in those teachers. I'm not talking about professors, they're a whole different breed, but teachers in public schools or even private schools, you know, you have your room to manage. Managing that room, no thank you, you know. Organizing or tracking the data of the kids and doing that, no thank you. Grading, testing and meeting the, like, there's so much involved with teaching than just teaching, and it's those other aspects, I think, that really make it difficult and strenuous for teachers. And teachers really do bring their work home, you know. They're at school 8 hours a day minimum, 5 days a week. That's a minimum. A lot of teachers do, you know, do at least 10 hours a day in the school setting, and they come home and they're not done with their job. They bring their work home, a lot of the teachers. And that's extremely stressful. The art teacher at the high school that I'm in, you know, she comes in at 6 in the morning. Our school starts at 8:40. 6 in the morning, prepares the lesson plans, organizes things, then goes home and then does, you know, there's something more. I think the way that this country and many other countries treat this teacher is just awful. We expect our teachers to do so much, and now they're going to be evaluated on how the kids do on their test scores. I mean, the teachers, it's really important to have high quality teachers. There's no doubt about that. But the pressure that the teachers have, especially in public schools, especially in public schools in areas where poverty is extremely prevalent, like, you know, South Bronx or the part of Brooklyn that I'm in, it's too much, I think. You know, I'm not saying only that, you know, teachers' salary should be higher, which I think they should be. The average salary of a teacher is just pitiful, you know, and when we think about what they're expected to do. Especially when we're comparing it to teachers and sports coaches, right? I think as a country, if we just look at the monetary value, I think America values sports coaches more than teachers. If we're just looking at the numbers, although just looking at the numbers doesn't give a full picture, you know? I mean, because we humans are emotional beings. There's much more things we do than just be like, oh, I give you this much money and that's what it means. No, there's more to it than that. But yeah, their salary is crap. You know, social workers, crap salary too, but let's not get in there. This is about teachers. Salary is crap, and the things they're expected to do, they need some assistance a lot. You know, I think if somehow, I mentioned this before, but if somehow every teacher was to be provided a teaching assistant or a teaching intern, that would be incredible. I think that would really help out the teachers in so many ways. If somehow public funds could be utilized to make that happen, then I would be all for it. Of course, that would raise the controversy, you know, Republican versus Democrats, like the country is getting, you know, we need to cut our spending down and the government is getting too bloated and big. And, you know, there are certain Republicans out there who think Department of Education should be a department that should just be eliminated completely, which is, to me, kind of terrifying. And the whole movement of charter schools, you know, let's get private companies involved and private corporations involved so that the education sector is more like the private for-profit business sector and more organized, blah, blah, blah. There's that argument there, which is also judging just because my experience with just looking at charter schools and how they're done, I'm personally biased against charter schools. But anyway, yeah, that's kind of the reaction I had when the kid was like, "You should be a teacher, Mr. David." I wonder what made him think of him wanting me to be a teacher instead of kind of like, you know, a social worker in the school setting. That's also an interesting aspect to itself. But I can't believe I had that gut reaction to the idea of teaching. When in fact, the profession that I'll be going into, my lifelong profession and passion, would be social work, which in many cases is even more, you know, stressful and under our salary or crap too, and you know, more underfunded, more overstressed, more overburdened, more overworked, more underappreciated, in some ways. It's about the same level in a lot of ways too. But yeah, it's ironic for me, you know, to have that reaction when I'm a social work student. Now, if I had that reaction and I'm a law student or like a doctorate student or, you know, a medical student, it wouldn't be as ironic because then I'll be like, you know, I'm going to be a doctor, I'm going to be whatever. But as a social work student, that was a pretty ironic response to have. But I just wanted to share that with you guys. Cheers.